Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mitesh Rana. Welcome to Roughbox, a learning companion.
So just a quick recap, Osha Chota, everyone remembers? Yeah, not any other Chota, Osha Chota. Sine, cos, tan, cot, sec, cosec, and then accordingly you get your ratios. I hope you've taken a screenshot, put it on the softboard, everybody, all those who done it, good job. Let's go ahead today with exercise 22B, part 1, sum number 2 I am beginning with. So sum number 2, there are no names over here, so first let's give them some names. A, B, C, D. BC is 6, 8, 17. So you remember the first thumb rule? Yeah, get all the sides, get DC and get AC. So AC by Pythagoras I'll get, correct? And then I'll take big Pythagoras triangle and I'll get full BD, and then I can break to DC. But DC I won't need, I will need BD only. So first apply Pythagoras, get the three sides and then get these ratios. Damn simple. Nothing new in the exercise, we are just repeating the same stuff. So let's go ahead quickly. So in triangle ABC, AB square, BC square, AC square. So AB is 8, BC is 6 and AC is unknown. So obviously AC is going to be 10. Since it's a triplet, I know it. So you, at least these two steps you write, the rest you might not write. Let's take the other triangle. So in triangle ABD, this bigger triangle, okay, 8 square plus BD square is equal to 17 square. So BD will be 17 is 289 minus 64, so that will be 225. So root of 225, I will get it as 15. So we get the entire BD as 15, that is this part. Yeah. Are you okay with me till here? So 15, 10, 8, 6, 17. I know all the sides now. Let's literally hit at each of the ratios. So sine x opposite upon hypotenuse. Now you may not write all that. In the earlier Excel we were writing so that we learn it well. Now that you've been thorough with it, you can go directly. So x ka opposite is AB. At least write the sides. And hypotenuse is AD. So that will be 8 by 17. So we got the first part. How many got this first part correct? 8 by 17? Great job. Cos y. So cos y. Y is here, so small triangle. Cos adjacent upon hypotenuse. So BC upon AC. 6 by 10. If you don't reduce this, you will lose one mark. You are expected to write it in the reduced form. Come on. Third part. This entire expression. So tan x, sin y, cos y. Cos y we've already found. These two we'll have to find. So let's find tan x. Tan x, x opposite upon adjacent. So AB upon BD. So AB is 8, BD is 15. Then sin y. Sin is opposite upon hypotenuse. So AB upon AC. So that is 8 by 10 or 4 by 5. Now I know 1, 2 and 3. So we shall use all this 3 and try to find this entire expression, the third part. So the third part says 3 tan x minus 2 sin y plus 4 cos y. So 3 tan x. Tan is 8 by 15. So 3 into 8 by 15. Sin y. Sin y is 4 by 5. And cos y. Cos y is 3 by 5. So I get 3 ones are 5s are, so 8 by 5, 8 by 5 and 12 by 5. So cancels, so I get 12 by 5, which is going to be 2, 2 by 5. Amni managed to get the same answer? Great job. Was it easy? Yeah. So the first sum, the second sum we did it, first is simple, so I thought we'll pick with the second one. Come on, everyone trying sum number 6. 3 and 4. Listen carefully. Sum number 3 and 4 are important sums. Circle them. We'll do them once we finish the entire exercise. So right now we're sticking to sum number 6. Come on. You got to find sin b. So sin b opposite upon hypotenuse. Where is your hypotenuse? We don't know. So the first thumb rule, if you remember, trigonometry applicable only in a perfect right angle triangle. Right angle triangle, if it is not there, what to do? I said create it. Superb. So you drop a perpendicular AD. So now this triangle I can apply tan B, sin B, whatever I want to. But for that first I need to find the value of perpendicular as well as BD. Since it's isosceles, the perpendicular bisects the base, so each will become 4. So I will directly write BD equals DC equals half of 8 equals 4. Before that, you can say draw AD perpendicular to BC. So this becomes 4, I got this 4. And now you can say in triangle ADB. Let's apply Pythagoras theorem. So AD square BD square equals AB square. So how much is my AD? I don't know. BD is 4 and AB is 5. So obviously 5, 4, so it has to be 3. We know that Pythagoras triplet. So 3 centimeters. Yeah. So I write this 3, 4 centimeter, 5 centimeter. Now that we've got all the sides, let's quickly hit at the ratios. So sine B, opposite upon hypotenuse, that is AD upon AB. So 3 by 5. Amni got this correct? Super, good job. Let's go ahead. Second part. Tan C. So C, tan, opposite upon adjacent, AD upon DC, 3 by 4. Okay, please listen to this carefully. Fine, once I finish the sum, I'll tell you. Sum number 3. I need sin B, which is already there. I need cos B now. So let's find cos B. B cos adjacent upon hypotenuse, that is BD upon AD. So becomes BD upon AB, sorry, hypotenuse. So that becomes 4 by 5. So I got cos B, I have sin B. So let's find this entire expression. That is sin square B plus cos square B. You remember we did this? And I told you it's going to help you in standard 10, sin square plus cos square is always equal to 1. So you will get the answer 1. Let's see how. So 3 by 5 square, 4 by 5 square. So 9 by 25, 16 by 25. So 9 plus 16, 25 by 25, 1. So as I told you, sin square plus cos square will always be equal to 1. Last part, tan C and cot B. So let's find tan C and cot B. So tan C first, C. So the opposite of C is 3 and adjacent is 4, AD upon DC. So AD upon DC, 3 by 4. The second part I need is cot B. So cot B, B adjacent upon opposite, BD upon AD. So BD upon AD, that becomes 4 by 3. Okay, let's take this expression, tan C minus cot B. Tan C minus cot B. So how much is tan C? 3 by 4 and cot B 4 by 3. So I get 9 minus 16 by 12. So my answer should be minus 7 by 12. Amni managed to get this correct. Great job. Okay, now listen to my instructions very carefully. On the YouTube, when your video is playing, you got 3 dots on the video. When you click on that dot, the last option you see is the speed, which says normal. You can click on that and increase the speed or reduce the speed. If you find I'm going fast, reduce the speed so you can match up. If you find I'm going slow, increase the speed so that you can match up. So you always have the choice of increasing or reducing the speed the way which I am teaching. Okay, let's go to the next question, sum number 8. Okay, everyone with me? 8th one, sign MT. This is the symbol of MT. Anyways, those symbols don't matter to us. What matters is sign. So sine will be opposite. Opposite is unknown. So first I'll find DC and find this one. Then we'll look at this later on. Come on, hit it. Get me till sine theta, everybody. Sine MT, everybody. So in triangle DCB, okay, I will say BC square plus DC square equals BD square. Pythagoras theorem. So BC is 12, DC is unknown, and BD is 13. We know Pythagorean triplet, DC is going to be 5. So I got this 5. So therefore sin MT is opposite upon hypotenuse, that is DC upon BD. So 5 by 13. Everyone managed to get the first part? Any doubts till here, anybody? 5 by 13. Okay, great job. Now tan theta. Theta, there is no right angle again. So what will we do? Create. Very good. So I drop a perpendicular and let's name this as E. So you say draw DE perpendicular to AB. So now my theta is going to be opposite DE and AE. So I'll have to find these two first. So this becomes a rectangle because 390 degrees. So if this is 5, this also is 5. entire is 14 already given to us. If this is 5 and this is 14, this will become 9. Now if this is 9, I still don't know these two parts. If this is 12, this also will be 12. So I got 9 and 12. Theta is opposite, tan is opposite upon adjacent. So I don't need AD as it is. So 9 and 12 is going to help me, but directly on diagram it's not going to work. We'll have to write entire stuff. So how will we write? So we will say in quadrilateral EBDC, angle E equals B equals C equals 90. Therefore quadrilateral EBDC is a rectangle. Super. Once you prove that it is a rectangle, therefore BC equals ED. Great. That becomes 12. So we got one part. DC equals BE equals 5. And therefore I can say AE, this part AE becomes 14 minus 5, that is 9. So finally now tan theta opposite DE upon adjacent AE. So that should be 12 by 9. 3 4s are, 3 3s are. So you should get it as 4 by 3. Amni got this correct? Alright, good job. Did you understand how to go about with the sum now? Any doubts? Anybody? If you have doubts, you have no choice. Repeat the video and see it again. I am not going to help you on this anymore. Sum number 9. 9 is again a good question, and then there are 3 parts to it. So it's a lengthy question. Let's go part by part and understand the question first. You've been given BC as 15. You got to find AB and AC. If I want to apply Pythagoras theorem, I need two sides. Two sides are unknown. So how will I go about it? So they have given me something additional this time, something new. Can you just start with this sine B opposite upon hypotenuse and do something and try it? Pause the video, try it, see if you can figure it out on your own, the first part. So if I say sine B is this, opposite is AC, hypotenuse is AB, correct? So what is sine B given to me? 4 by 5. So therefore what will happen? Let, tell me what, let. Super, AC 4x and AB 5x. So if AC is 4x and this is 5x, what do I do now? 4x, 5x, 15, perfect. Apply Pythagoras, get the value of x. Once you get x, substitute that in this and your AB and AC is there with you. Yeah. So let's try it. In triangle ABC, I'm applying Pythagoras. So AC plus BC equals AB. So how much is AC? AC is 4x, BC 5x, and AB, BC is 15, not 5x, and this is 5x, correct? So this becomes 225, 25x square minus 16x square. So 25 minus 16 is going to give me 9, 9 goes down, so 225 by 9 equals to x square. So x will be 15 by 3, which is equal to 5. Once I got this 5, can I get my AB now? Yes, how much is AB? 5x. So 5 into 5, 25 units or centimeters. No, not centimeters, units, because they have not given centimeters. So centimeter. How about AC? AC is 4x, so 4 into 5, 20 centimeters. How many managed to get these two? Great job. Now CD and AD is the next part. So CD is here, AD is here, and they have given you some more additional information, that is tan angle ADC equals to 1. So let us see how are we going to tackle this. Tan angle ADC, ADC is here, tan opposite upon adjacent, so AC upon CD equals 1. So therefore if I look at this, what do we get? Who got this clicked? AC equals CD. You already have AC, yes, how much? 20. So this CD also becomes how much? 20. So we got this 20, we got this 20. Can I now apply Pythagoras and get AD easily? So we managed to got AB, AC, CD. Now we are trying for AD. So let's apply triangle ACD, Pythagoras theorem. So AC plus CD equals AD. So that will be 20 plus 20 equals AD. So AD will be 400 plus 400, 800 ka root. Since you can't do anything to this, it's not a perfect square. You take the factors and convert this into pure surds. So when you convert to pure surds, it should be 20 root 2 because 20 goes inside becomes 400. 400 into 2 is 800 centimeters. You need not go to decimals. You can leave it here and they will accept it for sure. Now what is left is the last part. They say to prove that this is equal to minus 1. Isn't it simple? Why do I say simple? Because usually they ask us this much only and you have to find the answer. This time they have given you the answer already. You just have to solve and prove it, isn't it? So first find tan B, then find cos B. Substitute in this LHS, automatically you will reach here. So let's find tan B first. So tan B, opposite. So tan B, B ka opposite upon adjacent. So 20 by 15. Correct? So that becomes 4 by 3. The next one I need is cos B. So cos B, adjacent upon opposite, 15 upon 20. So that becomes 3 by 4. Now the expression tan square minus 1 upon cos square. So tan square B minus 1 upon cos square B, call it as LHS. So LHS 4 by 3 square minus 1 upon 3 by 4 square. Come on, now at least pause the video and try. How much you will copy, man? So this is going to be 16 by 9. 1 by 9 by 16. So 16 by 9, this goes up. 16 by 9. No, sorry, 9 by 16 by 9. Yeah, correct. So I have messed up somewhere, it seems. Okay, what a lovely mistake by me. Cos B, I took it as cot B. Cos B is adjacent upon hypotenuse, that is 15 upon 25. So this should have been 25. So this will become 3 by 5. So this is also 5. 5, so 25 going up. So this will be 25 by 9. 16 minus 25, 9 by 9, minus 1. So RHS also minus 1. Therefore LHS equals RHS. And therefore you can copy the entire expression, minus 1 upon cos square b equals minus 1. Yeah, did you manage to reach here? Isn't it a lovely question? So such type of questions you can certainly expect in the exam because lots of stuff has been asked. First we used sin b, and we used sin b, got AC, AB in terms of x, applied Pythagoras, got x and resubstituted. Then we used tan, okay. We said AC, CD, which very rarely it clicks to people, AC, CD being equal as 20. Then applied Pythagoras, got AD. And then finally we got this expression and found the value of that. It's a lovely question, trust me guys. You must take this sum seriously, so please don't take it lightly. Let's go to sum number 11. Come on everybody. Before we go to 11, a little bit of understanding. If you remember, in the start, I told you that there is a connection here. Sine with cosec, cos with sec, tan with cot. So the connection are all reciprocal to each other. So let's take an extension. Sine is equal to 1 upon cosec. Why? Because both are reciprocal to each other. See, if I take the reciprocal of this, I get this. Cos is equal to 1 upon sec. Likewise, can you tell me tan will be equal to 1 upon cot? Amazing. Cot will be 1 upon tan. Sec will be 1 upon cos. And cosec will be 1 upon sine. So this table is really important. Now that you put it on the softboard, update this also. So you can always remember what are the reciprocal ratios. So using the same reciprocal ratios, can you find tan and cot? What is the relationship? Tan and cot. So tan is 1 upon cot and cot is 1 upon tan. Likewise, sine and cosec is your next sum. That is 10th one. So sine and cosec, both are reciprocal to each other. Will you remember this much at least? Now try the sum. They have given you this and they want you to find the value of this. Obviously square is needed. So you are going to square both sides. So squaring both sides. So this will be a square plus b square 2 times ab equals 25. So this remains as it is, tan square plus cot square. Why? Because I need this. 2 times tan and cot. So what can I write for cot? I have already given you the hint. Come on, pick up the hint. So cot will be 1 upon tan. Super. Cancels. 2 goes on the other side. So tan square a plus cot square A becomes 23. Can you now do this one? Same type, nothing new, same type, come on, hit it. Squaring both sides, so I get A square plus B square plus 2 times AB equals to 4. What will I write for cosec? Start thinking. So sine square, cosec square, 2 into sine into 1 upon sine, because cosec is 1 upon sine as per the reciprocal ratios. Gets cancelled, 2 goes on the other side. So final answer, sine square plus cosec square is equal to 2. Easy? It's a very simple type of sum. If you are focused well, 100% you will get it. Come on, the next one. Sum number 14. Now this is slightly different. For this we'll have to have little more understanding. So before we reach here, a little more understanding. If you look at sine and cos and tan, what is the connection? Look at sine and cos carefully. If I divide these two, opposite upon hypotenuse divided by adjacent upon hypotenuse. So if I multiply the division sign, this reciprocal takes place, hypotenuse upon adjacent. So cancels. What do I get is opposite upon adjacent. Is that tan? Yes, it is. Opposite upon adjacent. So that means tan can also be written as sine upon cos. Are you understanding? Tan can also be written as sine upon cos. Likewise, cot can also be written as cos upon sine. When you divide these two, cos by sine, you will get this. Okay, so this is what we are going to use in this sum number 14. So please try and pay attention to that. If you not followed, repeat the explanation again, rewind, understand it, and then only come to this sum. So this is what you have to find, and this is what is given. So 5 cos A minus 12 sin A. Come on, use your brains. Think how are you going to go about and tell me the logic behind this. So first I will push this on the other side, okay? 12 sin A. What to do now? I just taught you some logic, right? Sin upon cos. So can I bring this cos down? So sin A upon cos A. Sin A upon cos A. So this comes down, 5 stays there and 12 goes down. What is sin upon cos? Tan. So we managed to reach to at least one of the ratios. Now that you know one ratio, can you manage to get the other ratio as well? All the other ratios possible? Yes. How is it possible? Obviously, you are going to take the triangle and work it out. Come on, pause the video, everybody. Now it's normal. Get sin A, cos A using the triangle and then substitute the values. Come on, hit it. Alright, let's take it forward from here. So I have tan A as 5 by 12. So I take the triangle first. ABC. And we will say tan A is opposite, so opposite is BC, adjacent is AB, so that will be 5 by 12. So let BC be 5x and AB be 12x. So BC 5x, AB 12x, Pythagoras I will get this as 13x. Triplet, no? So we know it, but you need to show the steps, huh? Please don't show direct work, otherwise your marks will be deducted. BC equals AC. So AB is 12x square, BC is 5x square, and AC we don't know. So AC becomes 13x. Now that I've got this 13, I need to find all the ratios, sine and cos A. So first let's find sine A. So sine A opposite upon hypotenuse, that is 5 by 13. Correct? Then cos A, adjacent upon hypotenuse, so 12x by 13x, 12 by 13. Now that I have these two, let's substitute it in this expression. So sin A plus cos A, sin A plus cos A upon 2 cos A minus sin A. So sin A we managed to get 5 by 13 and 12 by 13. So 5 by 13 plus 12 by 13, use the division sign, it becomes easy to understand. 2 times 12 by 13 minus 5 by 13. So I get this 5 plus 12, 17 by 13, 24 by 13, bigger box, minus 5 by 13, correct? So 17 by 13, 24 minus 5 is 19, reciprocal, so 13 by 19 gets cancelled, 17 by 19. How many managed to get this answer correct? Yeah, it was a good question, isn't it? Some number 14. How many got this? 17 by 19? Cool, good job. Last sum for this video, sum number 15. Come on, everyone should try this. It's a tricky question, slightly different but interesting. Not difficult, but different. Okay, so no values given. Just these two expressions you need to find, and the only important mark is given to you is that D is the midpoint of AC. So if D is the midpoint, I can say AD equals DC equals half of AC. This is a very important expression which is going to help us throughout. Reason, since D is the midpoint of AC. Okay, now let's see how can we work this out. Let's take the first part. Tan angle CAB upon tan angle CDB. Be with me, it's very simple. CAB, that means full triangle. Tan means opposite, that is BC, upon adjacent, that is AC. So I got the first one, divided by tan CDB. CDB is here, the small triangle we are talking about. So CDB tan will be opposite BC and adjacent DC. So now what happens? BC upon AC. For AC, can I write 2 times of DC? Okay, we'll come to that. Wait, first let's reciprocal this. So BC gets cancelled. What I get is DC upon AC. So that is DC upon AC. AC can be written as twice DC. Did you get that link? Cancels. So my answer becomes half. See, even without values, we managed to get values. Isn't it interesting? The only interesting point was that D is the midpoint. Can you try the second part now on your own? It's amazing again. Tan angle ABC upon tan angle DBC. So ABC, this time we are here, and big triangle. So AC upon BC divided by DBC, small triangle. So DC upon BC. So AC upon BC into BC upon DC cancels. What will I write for AC again? 2 times of DC upon DC cancels. So what is my answer? 2. Isn't that great? A good question. Yeah, homework. I'm not giving you a lot of homework because I know the exercises are big over here and you got a lot of work from school as well. So exercise 22b, only 4 sums, 1, 7, 12, 13. Remember, 3 and 4 circle it. We'll do that in the next video. So until the next video, do all the sums in the video as your work and this as your homework. Please update on daily basis. I have seen a lot of people not doing their work on regular time. I'm going to send till end of April one video each day, Monday to Friday. If you keep on your work pending, it is going to pile up and you will never be able to cope up, and then you will copy everything, and when you copy, you are not going to get any marks. So please see to it, you don't do all these mistakes. Keep yourself updated, don't be lazy, stay safe, be healthy, and pray for all of us. Bye, take care guys.
Hope you had a lovely mathematics experience with Roughbox, our learning companion.